people cheering you up. Terry Hart is here with a special exclusive on BT. Terry,
I love an exclusive. Well, people are going to be losing their minds this November. Frozen is back, Elsa's back, Anna's back, Olaf's back, and we love them all. The same voices are coming, and it's a whole new kind of world, but a world that we're familiar with. Elsa discovered her powers in the first one, and in this one, she discovers why she has those powers. But that's wrapped up in all kinds of danger. Look at that animation. It's so beautiful. Let's take a look. It's a BT exclusive. We're super excited for this. Let's take a look at the advanced trailer that only you can see right here on Breakfast Television.
Right now.
Enjoy! We have always...
Elsa, the past is not what it seems. You must find the truth. Go north, across the enchanted lands, and into the unknown. But be careful. Always feared Elsa's powers were too much for this world. Now we must. They are enough.
I won't let anything happen to her.
Ooh. Yes!
Gorgeous.
Yes. Yeah, November 22nd of this year. Now, there was no actual music in that trailer, but all of the same songwriters are back. Of course, anybody who saw that movie had Let It Go in their head for months and months and months, and it's a good one. I just listened to it again, and it brought tears to my eyes. Such a great song.
It's the song we can't let go because it's so good.
The cold never bothered me anyway. Love that line. And they're all back, and I love those voices. You might not realize this, but Frozen actually became the highest-grossing animated film of all time.
Is that something?
$1.2 billion worldwide, which is incredible. So a lot of people are looking forward to this. This trailer debut is exciting for many. November 22nd, 2019. But, you know.
It looks gorgeous.
It's a while away.
This like, film. Absolutely stunning looking.
Yeah, I mean,
Go ahead, such a fresh script. It was lightning in a bottle. You had the two female protagonists. It's all about that bond as opposed to... It was just such a fresh take on the on a new story. And it really did take off.
And a lot of people kind of brought it back to what they call the Disney Renaissance days when, you know, Aladdin, Beauty and the Beast, Lion King, all those movies came out. And then we had Frozen, which kind of brought us into a new decade in terms of women, female characters in Disney movies. It was super progressive. People loved their daughters falling in love with Elsa and Anna. They were powerful. They were strong. They took care of their own things. Anyway, it's a great, great thing that they've made another one. I can't wait for the music.
And
Idina Menzel can sing.
Oh, she can sing. She can belt sing. The layers, the laughter. Yeah. So, you know, the kids are laughing at one part, the adults are laughing at. There is something for everybody, and that's the reason why parents were saying, I think I've watched it about 75 times, and I'm going to watch it another 75 times, because it's a pleasure every time.
And when Disney does the side characters really well, they can become more popular than the leads. And that happened with Olaf. Of course, Josh Gad voices Olaf.
Yes.
He was so funny. He was, you know, I think about Dory. Who, you know, became just as popular, if not more popular, than Nemo. You think about the genie in Aladdin. You think about sometimes those side characters can bubble up ahead
of... They add so much to it, though.
And they often have the comedy, right? Yes. They're comic relief. They're silly. They make really great cuddle toys when you go to bed.
Yeah, scene stealers, right?
Do you have one? Do you have a little Olaf at home?
I do have Olaf.
Do you really?
I really do. I love Olaf as a character.
I love Olaf, too.
And for Canadians, I think it's really great that, you know, a snowman is, you know, the side character.
Now, so, I was a little worried for him when he's going down the river because I'm thinking a snowman and a river.
I know.
Science.
Yeah,
but this
I'm doing
is magic,
here.
Roger.
Okay, yes.
When we were watching that, Roger, your face was amazing. You were like, oh my God.
Well, really, it's just stunning. It looks beautiful. It looks real.
What they're able to do now, there are certain things in animation that the technology has allowed them to do with fur. with water, with ice. Mm-hmm. And that's all encompassing in Frozen. So I think the technology, if you're kind of an animation geek and like to see year to year how much progress the art form has made, I think we're going to see a lot of progress in Frozen 2.
Now, I know it's early, but is there an Oscar buzz?
Listen, it won the best animated Oscar. Anytime Disney releases an animated movie, you kind of anticipate that there's going to be Oscar buzz around it. Thank goodness for that best animated category. Yeah. I'm so happy it exists.
It's world class.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just going to say, I know you guys are going to see Toy Story 4 today.
Yeah,
yes. I saw it this weekend in Orlando. Bring tissues.
I can't wait. I think I told you the story. I ugly cried when I brought my niece. She looked up with her little glasses. Like, are you going to be okay? She was so
For Toy Story 3?
Yes.
Well, I mean, it was ugly crying. Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Like, hose down my face. Like, it was just, it was bad.
It's so great to have Buzz and Woody back. I was really, I'm just happy that they've made it. Anyway, Frozen 2, November 22nd, 2019. It's early, but I'm hoping I'll be able to interview them.
Yeah, I think you will. Something tells me yes.
Okay.
But they just make movies like nobody else.
Yeah. They do.
You know, it just brings you to that amazing place.
It's the magic of Disney.
Yeah.
You know, they know.
Lots of movies, but good ones.
Yeah, absolutely.
Thanks, Tara. So, that was exciting.
I'll be back later.
Can they watch that on our website over and over with
the
kids?
I think they can watch it over and over with the kids.
There you go.
And then watch the Let It Go video. Yeah. It'll bring you right back.
All back.
The 20th.